Oh, I'm. What about you?
That's good to hear. All right. Well, some brief introductions I think are in order. My name is Samuel Foreman. I've been teaching English online for about 7 years now. What was that?
Cool. My experience of speaking English is like 5 years.
Okay. You sound like you. We'll keep talking and I'll evaluate how you sound. You sound like you've got a pretty good handle on English. I don't think I need to slow down much for you, but we'll see.
Okay, fine.
Let's see. Well, for some students, I needed to speak like this or they won't understand me. Or
Oh,
worse.
yeah. I have got quite
Others.
the same with my mom,
Yeah.
because we start the challenge with my mom when she's trying to learn English too, but she can't really speak it. So we in our house, me and my mom speaking only English, and sometimes I'm talking slow like this so she can understand.
Yes, well, I try to match the level of each student I work with, and I try to. What the idea is this: any level of English or any language for that matter, you always want to be pushing someone to the point where it's a challenge, but not to the point where they have no idea what they're doing. And you're at the point where there's no way I could put you in a position where you have no idea what you're doing, I think. Well, if I do,
Yeah.
then I'll throttle it back and try again.
I think you can speak with your normal speed because
I am.
I'm already studying in England for 1 year
I
and
was about to
so.
mention, I'm hearing a mixture of English, I'm hearing a mixture of British and Russian accents here, and it's got an interesting
Yeah.
mix to it. Very nice. All right. So let's see, a bit about background and interests. I'm originally from Los Alamos, New Mexico, in the United States, which kind of gives me a, that places me in the kind of Californian accent region. If
Yeah.
that matters to you.
I'm always think
Yes.
that my accent is quite bad because usually if you I'm ra most of Russians have got bad accent in English.
Well, I can hear the British in your accent, which when it
Oh,
mixes with
fine.
the Russian accent, that has a kind of a, it's a fun combination.
Yeah.
But yeah, you can hear the British with the Russian, and yeah, it's perfectly understandable, but it's an interesting, it's a fun
Okay,
accent to
fine.
have. It's a fun accent to have. All right, let's see. Background about me. I write science fiction. One of my favorite things to do is tutor writing. I also, you could say I specialize in tutoring English through games, but I'll use whatever materials you're interested in.
Okay,
And
fine.
with no, I might as well give you a quick introduction of some of the materials I use.
Okay.
One of the basic things I have here are pictures. And of course, pictures are great for every level of students. From the most basic to the most advanced students, pictures are useful because at the lower levels, you can do basic things like talk about colors and just basic vocabulary, what do you see here, kind of stuff. At more advanced levels, you can talk about what could you do to turn this picture into a story and various other things. And I like this website because it has pictures of absolutely everything. You can see it clearly.
Yeah, fine. And can I ask you, what time is it now, in your place where you're?
Where I
Because it's.
live, it is currently 9:13 a.m.
Oh, fine. Because it's 9:13 in the evening for me. So is it morning, in you know?
Yes, it is morning for me.
Oh. Because for me, this time is not that good because it's already evening and sometimes I'm become tired.
Would you like the
Is
class to
it
be earlier?
good? I don't think so. If you'll start a bit like hour early, it will be not comfortable for you because it's
An
morning.
hour
Is it
earlier for me will work on almost every
possible to
day.
make something like it will be 9 o'clock in the evening for you and 9 in the morning for me?
That's entirely possible. That might be. Ooh, I'll need to talk with my wife about that one.
Okay.
That's going to, that would, yeah, that's going to cut into my evening time, which is kind of my family time.
Oh, so if it's your family time, we don't need to do it. So
I'm flexible. But if you would like it to be a little bit earlier for you, I mean, I can do an hour earlier without a problem.
Oh, if it will be an hour earlier, it will be quite good for me.
Let's actually check that. Yeah, an hour earlier. Yeah, we can do an hour earlier. Let me go ahead and just change that in my schedule one moment here.
Okay, fine.
Right here. So tell me about some of your interests. What are things you like to do? What are things you like to use English with?
I like reading. I enjoy reading by all languages like Russian and English. If we will talk about the sport, my favorite sport is volleyball. I'm not that good in volleyball. I started it like half a year ago. But before volleyball, I was playing chess a lot. I like 6 years of chess in my experience. Like I was playing chess for professional. I was in the world champion and Europe. I even was in top 20 in Russia championship. So chess is like something that I was doing nearly every day. But wow. Now I'm not playing chess because it's become a bit boring for me. And just I don't really play them now.
Okay, for me, chess, I know how to play chess. I am nowhere near a professional level of chess play. People who play chess casually, I can often win, but
I might possibly win me because it's already like 1 year or more when I'm not even try to play chess only with my dad.
Yeah. As a child, I played chess until I could beat my dad, basically. And he's smart, but he's not like... Chess? Yeah, that'd be interesting. I do actually have a game that I designed. He's not here with me. As someone who's extremely experienced in chess, you might be able to assess this game. It's a lot of people compare it to chess when they see it, but it is not.
What is the name of this game?
It's a game I created. You won't have heard of it. I'm actually trying to decide on the name. My wife recommends the name Space Cubes. It's actually a game I designed to go along with the science fiction novels that I write. And it's supposed to be kind of the traditional game of the alien civilization.
I think it will be interesting to try to play it.
We could try that at some point. I don't have it here with me right now. I'd have to get it out. But yeah, we could try that at some point. To do that, I would probably just adjust the camera so that you could see the board. And then we would use that. But it is... it's designed for 2 to 8 players, so you can play with just two people, and that's fine. Actually, I'll show you a picture of it.
Okay.
Let's bring that up here. I have pictures of it where... Let's get the better picture if we can get it. I do not see the better picture, so we will go with the good enough picture.
Don't really matter.
Here's kind of the prototype I was using. You can see what it... This is basically what it looks like here. For two people, it's normally on a 6x6 board. If you want more than two people, I usually play on a 12x12 board. And
it's looking quite good.
All the pieces are the same. There are, of course, you can see the cubes there. Each cube, of course, has 6 sides. There are 3 sides for the white team, 3 sides for the black team. And when there are more than two teams, I have a different cube that I use that has a little hole in it. And you can put flags in the hole to indicate who it belongs to. And the pieces move differently depending on which side is facing up. There are, the game functions like there's three different pieces, even though they're really just different aspects of the same piece. And I can go over the rules about how you change from one side to another and how you capture. The basic objective of the game is to capture all the pieces on the other teams. Though, if the game goes on too long, you could just count whoever has the most pieces at the end, and the team with the highest number of pieces wins.
This actually sounds really interesting. Mm-hmm.
It's the difference between, one of the big differences between this and chess is that chess is a game where all things always deteriorate. You take pieces and they never come back onto the board again. And here, when you take a piece, it just changes from one team to another. So in theory, you could be pushed down to where you just have one piece left, and then you start to take them back, and you could make a comeback from there.
This is quite a big difference.
And in practice, that very rarely happens. It can happen when you have more than one player, and one person gets pushed down to where they have very few pieces, and the other two are stuck against each other, and the player with very few pieces left manages to get some back and manages to make a comeback. That can happen. I have better pictures here for other games. And what you can, of course, see here with the white, and white is clearly winning here. Black has a piece here and here, and they have a cluster of pieces over here. Looks like they have another one over here. It's hard to make out. The image quality isn't that good for this one. But that's the general idea behind space cubes. Right.
This look really cool. I like this game.
We can practice that a different day. Pictures. I discussed pictures. Hypothetical questions or just conversation questions. I like this site for a lot of the conversation questions you can get on it. I actually prefer the philosophical questions, but there are conversation questions of all sorts that we can use as well. It's just general discussion is fun. And good just conversation practice, of course. Quotes are another basic tool I like using for students of nearly every level. Obviously, the lowest level students won't be able to jump right into quotes, but the idea being that I read it, you read it, and then we can talk about it. I use this for grammar practice, in fact, where I will tell, after we've read this quote, how would you rephrase this quote to say it as in something, say it as if it is something that is going to happen tomorrow, if you were to practice future tense. Say it as something that almost happened, but didn't quite happen. If you want to practice not conditional, but other, those are all the different tenses of saying something that's happening and then you got interrupted if you want to practice the continuous, stuff like that. But those are all ways that I practice grammar with this. I'm giving you the tour of some of the different tools I use, that's all. I like using webcomics. This is a webcomic I like to use. It looks...
Oh, they're quite funny. I like this one.
Yeah. Do you know about Order of the Stick?
No.
Okay, you don't know this particular webcomic. Okay. Well, this is based off of games that's a game called Dungeons & Dragons, which I actually have my own version of it that I didn't modify it for using English. I actually created it from scratch back when I was in college. And role-playing games like this are a fairly common thing I will use for a teaching tool. It depends. It depends on your interests and other things. One of the other things I've been known to do, in fact, I could go do a quick one with you right now with this. For example, I would describe a place. I have actually a thing here where I'm using for kind of a map and description, where I would say something like this. You find yourself standing on an old bridge in the middle of an abandoned city. You can see empty buildings around you, and there is no sign of movement anywhere. As you look away from the bridge, you can see that the bridge continues to the north. Behind you is an abandoned plaza, and to the east and west, you can see other groups of abandoned buildings. What do you do? And then you tell me whether you go to the north, south, east, west, whether you investigate the bridge, or you look around other things around you like that. And we just do and forth thing like that. Because I actually have a map and other things that's, it's all procedurally generated. All I'm looking at here is a spreadsheet that gives me all the information for this stuff. And with a push of a button, I can recalculate it and it'll be totally different. And I use this for this. I have actually storytelling and other stuff that goes along with this. And it works a lot like Dungeons & Dragons, where, have you heard of Dungeons & Dragons?
Not really.
It's a role-playing game where you have a group of people that each create a character and they form a group. It's a lot like this. This webcomic here is based off of Dungeons & Dragons. And
okay.
We can read this for fun, various things you can do to see it. This is how it starts, but it starts out looking kind of like this. The first few strips are just jokes about the setting. And there isn't really a story until you get to number 13 or so. And it still gets, there's over 1,000 of these things now. So the story is still going. The story is not done yet. But we could pick a random one here and see, without too many spoilers. The art gets a lot better later on, as you can see. But it's still
so many comics.
It's all one story, and the story isn't done yet. It's very good for, it has lots of pop culture references and pretty good for general vocabulary, but we could do something like this if you're interested. But those are the basic tools I have. I also have a whole bunch of other, teaching resources here. You can probably see, I have other webcomics I use for business English. Dilbert, you may have heard of that. I like using Science News for more advanced students. Science News is basically a news website for science topics.
I like science. I can't say that I'm really good in science, but I like all this physics, biology, and chemistry.
Okay. Well, you can see here with Science News, this is more for reading practice. Of course, just like a quote, we can read it and then discuss it. There are topics under chemistry, earth, humans. Oh, that is an interesting snake. A pill for heavy metal poisoning may also help save snake bite victims. Life. That's actually more about memory and how that's neuroscience. Yeah, you can see the subcategory here, because life and subcategory of life is neuroscience and also ecosystems. Math. Using math to cook a perfect steak. That sounds vaguely interesting. The U.S. hasn't really it has resisted using the metric system, but anyone who studies science, anyone who has gone into a scientific field in the United States will be using the metric system. Generic people tend to use the standard system more, which is kind of funny because they got that from Great Britain and then Great Britain stopped using it. And of course, we have physics and other things. Astronomy is one of my personal favorites. I like astronomy quite a bit. It's probably because of the science fiction stuff.
Astrology is quite mystery because it's all stars and they can show you pictures of everything. So I think astrology is quite mystery.
Astronomy as opposed to astrology. There's a difference. Do you know what the difference is between astronomy and astrology?
Maybe astronomy is about stars and astrology is about everything else?
Not quite. Astrology is actually the precursor to astronomy. Before astronomy was a science, it was astrology. And as it became more rigorous, as it became a actual science where people would study it using scientific method, they had things like astrology. And astrology, people still use astrology today. It's just not considered a science. It's actually considered a pseudoscience. But originally, all the sciences were philosophy. And as they became, well, here's a fun question. What's the difference between philosophy and science? And it's actually a very simple difference.
Science is really specific, and philosophy is based more on rhetoric.
And yeah, it's philosophy is all about ideas, and I like philosophy quite a bit. I love talking about philosophy, but the basic difference, the real defining line between science and philosophy, is if it can be measured, it's a science. If it cannot be measured, it's philosophy.
It's philosophy.
Yeah, because you can measure the light coming from distant stars, you can classify where they are and things like that.
But you can't measure amount of them.
You can't. Well, you can count the number of stars that have been classified, but it doesn't matter. I mean, if you have a good enough telescope, you can look anywhere and find new stars because counting.
But there will be no end of them, the infinity.
Yeah. Well, that starts to get into kind of the theoretical astronomy, is what is out there, what's beyond what we can see. They call the limits of the visible universe, and it's simply the limits of the visible universe because we can't see beyond that point. That's the thing, that the farthest away that we can see is a certain point, and we don't see anything past that. And well, that's the limits of our observation.
Okay.
You get questions about, well, what's beyond that and what does it mean and so on and so forth. That's how they get the age of the universe, is they assume that, well, the farthest thing we can see must be the edge of, that's how you get the age of the universe, because otherwise that's how we define universe too, is everything we can see as opposed to everything we can't see. And we don't know how big everything we can't see is because we can't see it. All right.
Yeah, basically. And Samuel, only today, but can we finish 15 minutes earlier? Because I'm not really at home now. I'm in a birthday party of my sister. Okay. And yeah, thank you.
All right. So with that in mind, what kinds of things would you like to do for our class, starting out with? We can start with the web comics.
I don't really mind, but if it will be my choice, I will be really enjoy if we will start from web comics.
We'll do the webcomic then. Order the stick. Well, let's see. I guess the question is which webcomic, because we have quite a list. Let me show you. The ones that I use are, as you saw, Order of the Stick. There is also Dilbert. Freefall, I think those are the main ones I use. Of course, we can find others. Dilbert, have you heard of Dilbert?
No.
This is humor based around business English, and I actually haven't read this in a while, but it's short, tends to be very much to the point. This actually has a lot more to do with current events. Freefall, I have not been keeping up with Freefall, but Freefall is a much more science fiction themed webcomic. It is also very, very long.
Oh.
These are the more recent ones. It's like you can tell that the guy, he had it divided kind of into chapters, as you can see here, and these are back in what?
Yeah.
2013, 2014, and ever since 2014, he's just put it all into one big group. And there's the current one here. I haven't read the current one, so I don't know what the story has done lately. But it is basically the story of a human colony planet, and they have lots of robots on the planet.
Yeah.
And one, the main character is this guy named Sam Starfall, which is a non-human alien that they found and brought back, and he is inside a kind of a spacesuit thing that makes him look kind of human. But he is actually some kind of squid alien thing.
Yeah, fine. I think it will be quite interesting. We can start from it.
Music is better for pop culture references. Free Fall is better for philosophy. This is better for business and current events. So
I think we can start from Free Falls. I like it.
Okay. Well, I'll make a note of that, and we will continue that. When did you want to? Oh, the other thing I have been known to do. We use games sometimes. This is one example of a game.
Let's see. Oh, Fallout 4.
You know it. You know this game. All right. Well, you can imagine how I would use this for teaching English then. There's basically three rules I keep when using a game to teach English. It must have lots of content. Obviously, there's plenty of stuff to talk about. Lots of stuff in here. There need to be decisions that you make that make sense. That if you've played this, you know that it's a game that has lots of decisions to be made. You can decide where to go, who to talk to, who you want to be friends with or not. And it has to be easy to pause. Boom. You can pause in the middle of a conversation, talk anytime, and we can pause and talk about what you see here. It has the same advantage as using pictures, except it creates a context where you can use English. I don't think this would be necessary for someone of your level, but a couple levels below, this is really useful because often what students lack is they have vocabulary and they can kind of speak, but they don't really have a context to learn English in. They're studying English from a book. They're not using it in a context, and a game creates a context.
Yeah, but now I'm just, because of quarantine, I can't really talk in English because I went away from my English school. Right. And my mom said I need to just talk with you only because I don't need to forget my language. I don't really need to get high because I already enjoy my English. Okay. So I just need to keep practice. So I think games will be really good for me too.
Okay, well, there's other games we can use as well. If we can pick one you already know, it feels kind of like... I don't know, there's some pros and cons to picking one you already know.
I didn't play Fallout 4, I just heard about it.
Okay, well, you knew enough about it to instantly recognize it when you saw it, so...
No, I didn't. I just saw Fallout 4 in the left up corner.
Of course. You can read. Yes. We've verified that you can read.
Yeah. So I'm not really know Fallout 4 that well.
Okay. Well, we might consider that because I've been using Skyrim quite a bit to teach English. But when I discovered Fallout 4...
I played Skyrim a bit. I didn't finish Skyrim because it's quite hard. But I played just like maybe half of Skyrim.
Okay. The game being hard is not an issue when we're doing it this way, because I'm the one playing it, and you're just giving me whether it's tactical advice or saying who should we – tactical and strategic advice, because the tactical is
really
like,
mind.
Okay.
If you will play, I don't really mind what we're going to play. I enjoy everything.
You enjoy everything. Cool. All right. Yeah. Well, I've used – oh, goodness. What games have I used? I can show you a list of the games I've used. Using something like Chaotica is the game I designed, that would be purely spoken because there's no visual element. You can't see anything. It's just me describing places and you describing what your character does in those places.
Okay.
So, those are all options. And if you wanted to end early, we might as well end now. That's kind of the tour of the basic tools I use. And we will continue
When is going to be our next lesson?
Maybe our next lesson is Saturday. Monday. I have it scheduled Monday, Tuesday, and Thursday here. If you want lessons on Saturday, I'm fine with that. Oh, wait, no. Saturday, I have other classes at this time.
Oh, okay. Not a huge problem.
Yeah. But Sunday could work. Do you want...
Okay, possibly Sunday at 8 o'clock, 8 for you in morning, 8 for
Yeah,
eight in the evening.
In the morning for me would work. I have another student who was supposed to come back at that time.
Okay, we will just can.
He might not be back. Well, I'll coordinate things. Hey, if you want to go even earlier.
Can you give me your phone number so I can type you, or you can type me about
Message
information?
Message me in Skype.
Oh, okay, fine.
I'm always on Skype.
Yeah. It's my mom's Skype, and I don't really think we should use it. Can I tell you my Skype?
Certainly.
I will type you an email.
We can also use Steam. We can use Discord. We can use Facebook.
I think Discord will be the best one.
Right. Send me your Discord contact, or I'll send you mine. Give me a moment.
Just wait a second.
There we go.
One moment.
There. That is my Discord name.
Oh, where it is?
It is in Zoom.
Oh, yeah, I can see it. Okay.
So, yeah, message me there, and that'll work just fine.
I will add you in a second.
Okay.
Can't really find you. Wait, I type mine. Cause I can't find you.
Okay, it took me a while to figure out how that actually works.
I didn't type it in
right
place.
If you go to the top left, where you go to home, and then you scroll up
friends. Oh yeah, I gave it.
Yeah, I just saw it. There we are. Pending. There we go. And I see that. Accept.
Oh, yeah. I can see him.
Great. Okay. Let me go ahead and... All right. Well, that's good enough. We can do that. All right. Well, yeah, we can communicate through Discord. That would be fine. And
yeah, I think that's all.
Actually, I don't see you here.
But I can see you. You're now in my friends.
Right. You should be in my friends list too. I just don't see you. Send me a message.
Oh, yeah, once.
Great. I see you.
Yep. Okay. That's it for today.
That is it for today. Nice to meet you, Alex, and we will talk again.
Sam, have a nice day. Bye.
Yes, bye.
Bye.